Yo, so let's get right into it. Today I'm going to show you exactly how to make a long tube so that you can ship a painting that you did, that you rolled up, but it's longer than any other tube that you can get at any store or shipping sort of place. And you know, you have to figure out how to ship it. So I'm going to show you how to make a longer tube on your own just by combining two different tubes and make it strong enough so that you can actually sort of ship it and have it not fall apart. So what you need right now, a Sharpie to mark things, something to cut the actual tube, and this is my chop saw. I also have a hot glue gun to hot glue some things together, and I have tape, some shipping tape, so that I can sort of tape things together. So all these different tools right here, you can easily make a long tube long enough for whatever you need, and you don't actually have to sort of special order a tube from a special sort of shipping place at all, because I know sometimes that just takes a long time or they can be really expensive. You can just get two tubes at the local store and just put one together, because I know the longest one that they usually have is 4 feet long, and basically, you know, we need a lot longer, so this is how you're going to do it today. So let's start by using that extra tube to sit on top or beside that tube that you just got. And what we're going to do is mark off sort of that extra that we need. Give it like a 5-inch buffer to sort of add that cushion in there for the packaging inside. And then we're just going to break out that saw, or if you have like a hand saw or a knife, definitely you can use that as well. But I have a chop saw, which makes it super easy. So we're just going to chop it where we marked it off, as well as chop off an extra piece of that tube so that we can use something for the inside. So that piece that we're cutting now, we're just going to chop it down and then split it down the middle so that we can have it fold on itself. And that is what we're going to use as sort of like that joint, that connecting joint that sort of connects that extra piece of tube and our regular tube that we get at the store. So that is sort of what we're going to do now, is just fold it on itself, see if it fits. It fits. And then we're going to use that hot glue gun to just glue it to the inside. And you don't need a ton of glue, just a moderate amount as well, because we're going to fortify it with tape as well, but just a moderate amount will just have it sort of secure in there, and that is going to stop it from sort of bending on itself or just like folding on itself. This is going to be sort of like an extra sort of security so that it can connect the original tube and that extra tube piece that we just made. So just hot glue the other side, throw that extra piece on top of there, and basically now we have an extra long tube. You can add more glue in that seam so that you just make sure that it's super secure, that you know there's no gaps in between it. But if you have a chop saw that gets a really straight cut, it shouldn't be that big of a problem. So now we have an extra long tube that just provides that extra length that we need to ship whatever we need to. So let's set it side by side so you can see that it fits. And after that, I just make sure I add some more tape to it, so it just gives it a little bit more security. So this technique is something that I have been doing for a very long time. It is something that I just usually use when I'm shipping sort of large paintings, because when you're shipping large paintings, it's super expensive when they're stretched, but when you roll them up, it can be as affordable as $40 to ship cross country and have the customer just stretch it at a local frame shop when the painting is delivered. So that's basically how I have been doing it.
So now you're able to make your own shipping tube so that you can ship a canvas that is really, really large, and you can go as big as sort of FedEx and other shipping companies will allow you to, but now you're able to sort of not have to rely on sort of specialty shipping tubes. You can make your own. So use this piece of advice in your studio practice or just in life in general when you need to ship things, and I will see you next time. Peace.